So these are the two matrices of the same order here. It is a matrix of order 2. Even then this is also square matrix of order 2 here. You multiply it here. A into B is equal to 2, 3, 1, 2. Into the matrix 2 minus 3 minus 1, 2 here. Therefore, this is equal to multiply row with the column here. Multiply row with the column. 2 2s of 4. 3 into minus 1 becomes a minus of 3 here. Multiply this row with the second column here. 2 3s are 6 here. Minus of 6 here. 3 2s are 6 here. So it is a plus 6. Multiply second row with the first column here. 1 into 2 becomes a 2 here. 2 into minus 1 is a minus of 2 here. Multiply second row with the second column here. 1 into minus 3 is a minus of 3. Then 2 2 is a 4 plus 4 here. Therefore, this is equal to 4 minus 3 is 1 here. Minus 6 plus 6 becomes a 0. 2 minus 2 becomes a 0. And 4 minus 3 is 1 here. So, obviously, it is a identity matrix here. Yes, A into B is equal to identity matrix. Similarly, okay, B into A, again you will get the identity matrix only. Okay, so A into B is equal to I, B into A is equal to I F. Okay, hence B is called the inverse of A F. So this is called, okay, therefore B is called inverse of A. Inverse of the matrix A. And A is said to be invertible. Means it has an inverse here. Okay, it has inverse. So inverse of A is this here, B here. Therefore, we say that A is invertible. Okay. Inverse of A matrix by elementary operations. Let X, A and B be matrix of the same order such that X is equal to A into B. If A is a matrix such that A inverse exists, then to find A inverse using elementary row operations, we write A is equal to I into A. We write A is equal to I into A. And apply a sequence of row operation on A is equal to I till we get I is equal to B into A. The matrix of B will be the inverse of A. Okay. So here X equal to A B here. Okay. Here we have to find the inverse of the matrix A. Okay. In that case, if you want to use the row operation here, if you want to apply row operation, then you write the equation like this here, A is equal to I into A. Then apply the sequence of row operations here. Then apply the sequence of row operations on the equation A is equal to I till we get I is equal to B into A. In that case, B is called inverse of the matrix A. Similarly, to find the A inverse using column operations, then we write A is equal to A into I here. And apply a sequence of column operation on A is equal to AI till we get I is equal to AB. If you want to use a column operation, in that case, you write the equation in this form here. A is equal to I, A into I here. If you want to use a row operation, then write like this here. If you want to use a column operation, use this one here. A is equal to E into I. And apply the sequence of column operations till we get I is equal to AB. Okay, then B is called inverse of A. This is the procedure here. And a remark, in case after applying one or more elementary row or column operations on A is equal to I into A or A is equal to A into I, if we obtain all zeros in one or more rows or column also, of the matrix A on LHS, then A inverse does not exist here. Okay. So theorem, statement of the theorem is inverse of a square matrix if it exists is a unique here. Okay, every matrix has a unique inverse here. This is a statement here. Okay, so let us consider AB square matrix of order M here. Let ABA square matrix of order M here. Okay, if possible, let B and C the matrices B and C be two inverses of A. Or the matrix are A. Okay. If possible, let B and C be two inverses of A. Now we shall show that B is equal to C. Here we are taking B and C two different matrices here. And both are the inverses of the matrix here. Then we have to prove both B and C both are the same matrices here. Okay. So since B is the inverse of A, therefore by definition of inverse here, you can write here A into B is equal to B into A is equal to IR, take result number 1 here. By definition of invertible of the matrix here. If B is the inverse of A, then you can write like this here. AB is equal to B is equal to I. So similarly, C is also what here? C is also inverse of A here. Since C is also inverse of A here. Yes, again by definition, A into C is equal to C into A is equal to IR. Take result number 2 here. Okay. Now take here B is equal to. We can write B is equal to here B into I F because I is what here? Identity matrix here. I is the identity matrix. If you multiply any matrix to the identity matrix, you get the same matrix here. Okay, this is the property of the identity matrix here. So B is equal to B into IF. Okay. Then this is equal to write B as it is here. And I is there. Here take I as A into C. I is equal to what? A into C. So use here. A into C using result to S. You are using A into C is equal to I. So replace here. Then this is equal to. Now you use associative life. Remove this bracket and take a bracket for these two terms here. Yes, B into A. B into A into C here. So, using associative law. You are using associative law here. So, B into A C is equal to B into C here. Using first result here, B A is equal to what here? B is equal to I. So use here. Therefore this is equal to I into C here using result one here. Using K B A. B is equal to I here. Therefore write here. Again I is not identity matrix. So I into C gives what here? Again it is a C only because C is a identity matrix here. So therefore what will get here? B is equal to C here. This is our required result. The meaning here. Inverse of a square matrix, if it exists, is a unique here. Every square matrix has a unique inverse here. That is important. Theorem 4. If A and B are invertible matrices of the same order, then AB inverse is equal to B inverse into A inverse here. Okay. You know that in the previous definition here, so you know that A into B is equal to B into A is equal to I. If this condition is satisfied, then B is said to be inverse of A. And we are writing that B as A inverse here. Okay, B is said to be inverse of A. Hence, B is equal to what? A inverse. You can just change here. You can write here A into A inverse is equal to A inverse into A is equal to I. Okay. So, AB is equal to BA is equal to I. B is said to be inverse of A. Therefore, B can be written in this form here. A inverse. Therefore, you can write here A into A inverse equal to A inverse into A is equal to I. Okay. We are using this result here. Here, A and B are invertible matrices of the same order. Then, we have to prove AB inverse is equal to B inverse into A inverse F. Okay. In this case, AB into AB inverse is equal to IF. Okay. It is by definition here. You are using this result here. Okay. A into A inverse is IF. Like that, AB into AB inverse is equal to I. Okay. You are just multiplying both sides by A inverse here. That is the left side here. A inverse into AB is equal to then into S. A inverse into AB into bracket of AB inverse is equal to A inverse into IS. Okay. Pre multiplying both sides by A inverse here. Okay. Pre-multiplying both sides by A inverse. Pre-multiply means multiply left hand side. Post-multiply means multiply A inverse right hand side. So both sides are multiplying by A inverse. That is the left side only. Then use the associative layer. So there is a bracket here. Remove the bracket and take a bracket for these two terms here. Okay. So therefore this implies. Remove this bracket. Take a bracket for these two terms here. A inverse. Into A. Into B. Into. AB inverse is equal to. A inverse into I is again it is the A inverse only. Because I is the identity matrix here. Okay. Because A inverse. Into I is equal to I into A inverse is equal to again it is a inverse here. Therefore A inverse into I is a inverse. I is identity matrix here. Then this implies okay. And you know that A inverse into A is equal to what here? I. Therefore A inverse into A is a I. So use here. I into B into AB inverse is equal to A inverse is equal to A inverse because A into A inverse is equal to A inverse into A is equal to I. Okay, A inverse into A is I. And I is identity matrix here. If you multiply matrix to identity matrix, you will get the same matrix only. Therefore, this implies I into B is again the B itself here. Okay, again it is a B. So write here B into AB inverse here is equal to A inverse. Okay, because okay, so B into I is equal to I into B is equal to B only. Okay, then again multiplying both sides by B inverse here. So this implies pre-multiplying both sides by B inverse into B into AB inverse is equal to B inverse into A inverse here. Okay, pre-multiplying both sides by so B inverse here. Pre-multiplying means multiplying both sides left hand side here. Therefore B inverse into B into AB inverse equal to B inverse into A inverse. Yeah. Again, B inverse into B is what here? Identity matrix. Therefore, this implies I into AB inverse is equal to B inverse into A inverse. Yeah. Okay, using this result only. Okay, yeah, B inverse into B becomes IR. Yeah. Okay, because B into B inverse is equal to B inverse into B is equal to identity matrix. Yes, it is the identity matrix. Again, I is identity matrix. I into AB inverse is again AB inverse itself. Therefore, this implies here AB inverse. AB inverse is equal to B inverse into A inverse. Yeah, because I is the identity matrix. Okay, you know that B into I. I is equal to I into B is equal to B. Okay. A inverse into I is equal to I into A inverse is again it is A inverse only. Like that I into AB inverse is again it is AB inverse only. Is equal to B inverse into A inverse. So this is required result. Yes. AB inverse equal to B inverse into A inverse. So elementary operation or transformation of a matrix. Okay. So there are 6 operations on the matrix. 3 of which are due to rows and 3 of due to the columns, which are known as the elementary operations or elementary transformations here. Okay, total there are 6 operations here. So using these operations we are finding the inverse of the matrix here. Okay, so I will explain one by one here. The first here, the interchange of any 2 rows or any 2 columns. Okay, interchange of any 2 rows or any 2 columns here. Symbolically, the interchange of ith and jth row is denoted by ri interchange with rj. It is a notation here. And interchange of the ith and jth column is denoted by ci interchange with cj. Okay, it is a notation. In this case, these are equal matrices here. Okay. So here R1 interchange with R2 is denoted by this here. R1 interchange with R2. So both left side as well as right hand side, you interchange the rows here. Okay. Therefore, here CD, it is in the elements in the second row here, right in the first row. And AB, elements in the first row, right in the second row. This is AB. Is equal to, here 3, 4. The elements in the second row, right in the first row. 3, 4. And 1, 2, elements in the first row, right in the second row. Okay. So it is a interchange of 2 rows here. R1 and R2. Okay. Similarly, equal matrices are there. So interchange of C1 and C2. Interchange of C1 and C2. So denoted by this here. Therefore, here B, D, these are elements in the second column here. Right in the first column. B and D. A and C, they are elements in the first column. Right in the second column here. Okay. Then this is equal to 2, 4 elements in the second column here, right in the first column. 1, 3 elements in the first column, right in the second column here. So, it is an interchange of 2 columns here, denoted like this. C1 interchange with C2 here. Okay. So, one operation on row, the other operation on column here. So, second one. The multiplication of the elements of any row or column by a non-zero number. Okay, symbolically, the multiplication of each element of the ith row by k is denoted as ri, implies k into ri, where k is not equal to 0. The corresponding column operation is denoted by ci implies K into C I L. So example here, again these are equal matrices here. Therefore, I am taking a second wire R2. I am multiplying some constant here 5 into R2. Okay. In that case, first row you not change here. Let first row as it is here. So A, B, the elements in the first row. And even right hand side, 1, 2 R elements in the first row here. Not to change it here. Okay. Here, take a second row, multiply by 5. Hence, 5C, 5D, and right hand side, 5 3s are 15. And 5 4s are 20. Okay. So R2 implies 5 into R2. So similarly, so C1 implies taking here minus 3 into C1 here. Okay. So C minus 3 is some constant here. Okay. So in this case, take a column here. So second column keep as it is. Second column keep as it is, only first column is changed here. Okay. Therefore, both the left side as well as the right hand side here. Here, second column elements keep as it is, B and D. So, right here, B and D. And right hand side, 2, 4, keep as it is here. So not change the second row. I am taking first column, Second columns elements keep as it is here. So, take here first column and multiply by minus 3. Minus 3 into A becomes minus 3A. Minus 3 into C becomes minus 3C. Even right hand side also. Minus 3 into 1, minus 3. Minus 3 into 3 becomes minus 9. So it is C1 implies minus 3 into C1. So second column elements keep as it is. Multiply first column by minus 3. Okay, therefore, here the multiplication of the elements of any row or any column by a non-zero numbers here. So symbolically, the multiplication of each element of the ith row by k is denoted by ri implies k to ri. This is one example here. Here k value is 5. Similarly, the corresponding column operation is denoted by ci implies k to ci. So this is one example here. Here k value is minus 3. It is constant here. Okay, third option here. Third operation, the addition to the elements of any row or column, the corresponding elements of any other row or column multiplied by any non-zero numbers. Okay, so symbolically, the addition to the elements of ith row, the corresponding elements of the jth row multiplied by k is denoted by ri implies ri plus k into rj. The corresponding column operation is denoted by ci implies ci plus k into cj. Okay. So I'm explaining by taking one example here. Yeah, these are equal matrices here. Okay. So I am taking row operations here. So R1 implies R1 plus 3 into R2. Means multiplying second row by 3 and adding to the first row. Okay. Adding to the first row. So therefore, only first row changes here. Only first row changes. Second row does not change here. Hence, second row keep as it is. Second row elements are right as it is. So C and D are the elements in the second row. Even in RHS also, 3, 4, these are elements in the second row. Okay, only first row changes here. R1 plus 3 into R2 means multiply second row by 3, adding to the first row. So this is the second row. Okay, multiply by 3 and adding to this one. Means A plus 3 into C here. Okay. A plus 3 into C. Multiply by 3 and add to this term. So B plus 3 into D. So similarly in RHS also, multiply by 3 and add to this number. So 1 plus 3 into 3 here. 3 3 into 3 multiplied by 3 and adding to this number. Therefore, here are 2 plus 3 into 4 here. Okay. So this R1 implies R1 plus 3 into R2. Similarly, suppose if you take a column operation here. Okay. I am taking here C2 implies. So C2 plus. So 4 into C1 here. Therefore, second column changes here. First column elements keep as is. So these are the first column elements here. A and C. These are elements in the first column here. So write here A, C here. Okay, here multiply first column by 4 and adding to the second column here. Multiply by 4 and add to this here. B plus 4 into A. Hence B plus 4 into A. Here multiply by 4 and adding to this number. So D plus 4 into C is equal to. Even LHS also first column write as it is. Not to change here. Only second column elements are changes here. Here multiply by 4 and adding to this number here. So 2 plus 4 into 1. Then here multiply 4 and adding to this number. So 4 plus 4 into 3. Okay. So this is the third operation. Okay. Invertible matrices. The definition. If A is a square matrix of order M and if there exists another square matrix B of the same order M such that A into B is equal to B into A is equal to I. I is the identity matrix here. Then B is called inverse of A. B is called inverse of A. And it is denoted by A inverse, A raised to minus 1. It is A inverse. In that case, A is said to be inverted.